It's my pleasure to welcome, as a first speaker, my minister, Her Excellency Sharon Dijksma, the Minister for Agriculture of the Netherlands. Sharon, may I give you the floor?
Ladies and gentlemen, last Sunday, millions of people walked for changing climate change. Concerned citizen Leonardo DiCaprio said at the climate summit that our economy will die when our ecosystem will be destroyed. He called for decisive large-scale action. Mr. Ban Ki-moon clearly stated that our choices have to be bold. All reasons to act, we cannot wait till tomorrow, he said. Today we are to bring here that decisive large-scale action. Agriculture is nowadays rightly considered a key part of the solution. We have to invest in farmers, especially smallholders and women farmers. Farmers are key to increase production, to promote sustainable change across the entire agricultural system, and put fairness and the environmental in its heart. Partnerships between the private sector, research institutions, civil society and governments are needed more than ever to sustainably nourish over 9 billion people in 2050. So let us follow the lead of those who can really make a difference in climate-smart agriculture. Let us match every private dollar invested in climate-smart agriculture with a dollar from public resources. And let us also focus on increasing the capacity of farmers to cope with external challenges, particularly climate change. That is why we have been so active in putting climate-smart agriculture firmly on the international agenda. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, today I am proud to present you the results so far of a journey that we started 4 years ago in the Netherlands. A journey together with the World Bank and FAO and supported by key governments from different regions. It all started with the first global conference on agriculture, food security and climate change held in The Hague in 2010. The three issues were put on the same agenda for the first time and an action-oriented global movement was created. Our hunger for action grew when the second conference in Hanoi, Vietnam in 2012 took place. The third global conference in Johannesburg in December last year clearly marked the transition towards action. This conference forms the platform for the kickoff of the design phase of an alliance for climate-smart agriculture that is welcomed and kindly supported by the African Union and the Secretary General of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon. Today we present the Global Alliance for Climate Smart Agriculture. Over 100 partners, including governments, the private sector, international organizations, international foundations, academia, NGOs, and civil society organizations have joined forces in this alliance. And the alliance will support a sustainable and equitable increase in agricultural productivity and income, greater resilience of food systems and farming livelihoods to climate change, and reducing greenhouse gas emissions wherever possible. The Global Alliance for Climate Smart Agriculture will initiate and facilitate programs and projects on the ground. The alliance is inclusive, voluntary, and broad-based, and its success will be measured by its catalyzing role for action on the ground. Within this framework, the Netherlands government, together with the Clinton Foundation, is investing $12 million in climate-smart smallholders in Tanzania, Malawi and Rwanda. Together with Kofi Annan's AGRA, we focus on climate-smart programs in a range of African countries. And we will also invest $5 million for programs in climate-smart agricultures, culture in countries in Africa and Asia, such as Ethiopia, Myanmar, and Vietnam. But it's not only funding, as we will also bring companies and private sector investment with us, as well as our technology and practical know-how. That is what is known as the so-called Golden Triangle approach. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, food security cannot be sustainable without sustainable fisheries. Fish contribute 70% of the animal protein consumed by the world's population. And such, it is a critical source of food, and demand is expected to double over the next 20 years. Over 800 million livelihoods are directly dependent on fisheries, and the numbers are growing. 80% of all life on the planet is found in the oceans. We need healthy oceans more than ever. At the same time, ocean health is threatened by habitat change, pollution, and overfishing. That's why we need a new wave for the world. The Oceans Action Summit, held in the Netherlands this year, called for the championing of a new concrete and innovative action and partnerships, especially in the field of blue growth and food security. An inclusive, voluntary global action network for blue growth and food security could bring forward and accelerate concrete actions and partnerships. And I am proud to announce that this global action network will be launched in Grenada in January next year. Ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by saying that the Netherlands government is proud to be part of the CSA movement. I count on your support. Let's join forces in the Global Alliance for Climate Smart Agriculture, an alliance which will seize opportunities and deliver results. The science is clear, the economics is compelling, and now we also have the political leadership to make it happen. Thank you.